Hey everyone, it's Natasha. In today's video, I'm going to review IQ Circuit. It is a smart games game. I got this from Timberdoodle in a recent haul, and so I wanted to review it for you today. I also have a review on another smart games game called Apple Twist. I'll link that one down below too. So IQ Circuit is a one-player game. It's for ages 8 to adult, and there's 120 challenges from easy to expert. This one is extremely handy for on the go. So let me show you. This is a perfect game to stick in your purse or diaper bag or the kid's backpack, to keep in the car, in the center console, wherever, to take into restaurants, because this is it. Okay, so in here, let me open it up for you. I have the guide that you need, and then I have all of the pieces. So essentially, you are putting together different variations of circuits with these pieces. These pieces are double-sided, and so they are different on each side too. So that's something that it gets confusing when you're putting circuits together, because you have to look at both sides of the piece sometimes to see which one you need. Okay, so there are the starter, junior, expert, master, and wizard. And in the starter, it says the shape of the paths and the shape and position of some puzzle pieces is shown. So here we can see in the starter level, it starts off this, like number one is literally showing you how to put them together. So number one is great for literally starting, or for those younger kids. I find starting at number one and just working your way through the puzzles is the best way to go, because it gets you familiar with the pieces, it gets you familiar with the concept, and it gradually works you into it getting harder. Because if you try to jump into the expert ones right away, you might struggle a bit. I'm just saying. So for this number one, you would literally go through here, look at the pieces, and try to make it match number one. Okay. And it progressively gets harder. So then we've got the junior, where the position and shape of all the puzzle pieces is shown, but not the shape of the path. Attention, some puzzle pieces have the same shape. So let me show you the junior. Okay, so you can see the dots and you can see the shape. Then the expert, the shape of all paths is shown. Master, the shape and position of some puzzle pieces with dots is shown. And wizard, only the position of the dots is shown. So let me show you a wizard here so you can see. These are the solutions. Okay, that's it. Once you get to wizard, that's it. Okay, here's another thing to know. Depending on how many dots you have is how many different like circuits you have. Okay, so if there's two, that means that you're gonna connect this to this in one circuit, basically. You know, so it has to, no matter how you're connecting it, it has to all flow. If you have this, you're going to have two different paths, right? You're going to have two different circuits. Does that make sense? So, for example, let me go back to this starter one. You see, we have, let's count the dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 dots. And so there's 3 different paths here, right? So, as you can see in that wizard level, look at these 2 dots. And somehow all the pieces have to connect these 2 dots. And that's all you get. That's all your show. So it gets really challenging, but that's great. Because like I said, if you start in the starter and work your way up, it doesn't feel as intimidating as if you like jump into the expert or wizard level. It does have these solutions in the back. Now, at the beginning, the solution looks exactly the same as the starter, as the, you know, let me show you what I mean. So if you look at number one here, it looks just like number one here, because like I said, it starts off so easy. But let me show you the difference in number 120. That's the last one. shoot 120 there, okay? So if you want to check out your answers, you can do that as well. And you just work them out right in this little carrying case. And I like to stick the booklet right on top so I can carry it with us. And of course, here's the box too. So I hope that was helpful. Like I said, I love the smart game, one player logic games. They're fantastic. I highly recommend them for your kids, for car schooling, waiting for siblings, waiting in restaurants, waiting at appointments, just waiting for you while you're working with another sibling, or if you don't have any siblings, just good critical thinking to add this into your daily homeschooling rhythm. I mean, I really think this is great for like a morning basket activity or even an after lunch activity, just to get the mind kind of going again. Definitely recommend these games. So if you have any questions, let me know, but check out the link below where I will show you where you can find it on the Timberdoodle website. And make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you love critical thinking and logic type games like I do. And don't forget to subscribe if you love all things homeschool.